This is a podcast 75 years in the making. It's a podcast about history.
Bring pork chops and applesauce.
It's a podcast about family.
The love is deep for her.
But most importantly, it's a podcast about you.
Sounds kind of weird.
It's season 3 of the official Holiday World Podcast, chronicling our 75th year of family fun.
Friends, welcome back to a special edition of season 3 of the official Holiday World podcast. This is season 3, episode 19 and a half, because why not?
Sure.
The one with the season pass excitement. Today is Thursday, October 7th for us, but we expect to release this episode October 11th. I like how my notes still say welcome back to whoever is here. And Sabrina's the only person.
Hi.
So we've kind of arranged this as a way to, you know, we're releasing this on October 11th and our season pass deadline is October 14th. So that's the last day you can get the best discounts of the season. They're currently $55 off. I keep looking at the experts in the sound booth of Josh and Steven. And this is a situation where we really are transparent about our season pass pricing here. It just gets more expensive from here. You know, the discounts get a little bit smaller as you go because we want to thank the people who commit early. So. Right.
And then now, too, if you start the payment plan early, too, then your payments are going to be smaller throughout the entire time.
Exactly. So we've invited, and by we, I mean I have invited to Sabrina. I don't
really. It's a very formal.
I'm not used to. Also, we're sitting very far away from each other. It's an interesting world. Sabrina was a season pass holder before she got hired and low-key confessed to that at her job interview. Yes. But as someone who actually, you know, used to purchase season passes, but who is now a super Holiday World expert, was already a Holiday World expert.
I tried to play it cool in the interview anyway.
You did. After the fact, I was like, oh, so you're like, once you got hired, where I was like, oh, she's for real.
Yeah, we went all the time as pass holders. And it's so fun to look back at those pictures too, like before, and like our kids, like they were like, they're super fans now, but they had drank the Kool-Aid like very early.
That's awesome. How did you start getting season passes? Have you always had season passes?
When Madeline was about 18 months old, someone gave me tickets through the newspaper. I've always worked in marketing and advertising and PR. And someone just gave me, for being an advertiser, he's like, hey, do you want 2 tickets? I was like, absolutely. So we went to the park and we had an absolute blast. And she actually gave us, we had enough that my mom and sister, who have both worked at the parks at different times since then. You know, so we all went and we just had so much fun. And we were already like with having Madeline. She was our first child. Our house was full of toys. And the holidays were super overwhelming because her birthday comes right after Christmas. And so...
Oh, those poor holiday babies.
I know. And like, luckily with her, it's in January. So there's a little bit of time. But not much, especially when it comes to all the plastic in your house and toys and like very thankful that, you know, she's a blessed little human, but it was just a lot.
Yes.
And we started early on and then my sister is also active. They're active military, so they move a lot. So like we both were just talking about how, you know, we just wanted to minimize the toys and we really wanted to focus on experiences and, you know, how we could, you know, gift those things to our kids. So it took a little bit of convincing because everyone wants to, you know, grandparents, they want to give gifts that they can unwrap.
Kids' faces don't quite light up immediately with recognition with like a piece of paper for the season pass voucher.
Paper you can't use for a little bit.
Yeah.
I get it. Our mom got really good at, so it took a little bit of time to warm her up to the idea, but she finally came around to, you know, that's what she would give our kids for Christmas every year. And so, I think we like started as summer fun card. We like started there.
Okay, nice.
And then the next year we went up to the regular season pass. And then it went to 1 platinum pass holder per family. And then we found out the platinum pass holder party was really fun. And so we all wanted to go. the summer actually that I was working, actually I interviewed. So I the day that I interviewed for Holiday World, I did my interview in like a suit, which is probably the last time I've worn a suit at Holiday World. Hindsight, like, what in the world was I thinking?
Or your first day of work.
Yes.
Because I've seen the photo. I was.
Yes.
Of course, they scheduled your first day when I was out of town. I'm like, cool, boss.
Sure.
But yeah, no, we're not suit people.
No. And so, which totally fits my vibe.
Yeah.
But yeah, so I wore a suit and went to my interview, I was like, you know what? I put it all out on the table. I'm going to go enjoy the day with my family. So sure enough, we went to the park and used our passes and played for the day. So we kind of started at Fun Card. That was a great way to get our feet wet.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we had little ones. We didn't really want to be in the rush of, you know, the crowds on whenever mm-hmm. we could go. So that worked out perfect for us. Yeah. But
and I've liked that you've shared before that you strategize with your kids with your season passes as well, and like when we ride rides in the season and when we do different activities.
Yes.
Share more.
The season pass is really like having a key to the park is what it felt like for us, because we, you know, especially when our kids were little, they really lived and died by that nap time. So we would come up, you know, after nap time or before nap time or after a meal. Mm-hmm. And in the early season before the water park was open, we would really make sure we hit those rides, because we knew, as we're, you know, it's pretty local, that July and August were going to be the busy months. And mm-hmm. it was also going to be hot. So we always hit. We're
it's
like,
a little less fun to wait in those same lines too. Yeah.
Yes. And, you know, we want to save spot in line for, you know, we kind of use this reasoning to the kids. It's like, hey, you know, a lot of times these are, you know, it's their summer vacation. Let's give them our spot in line. And like
aww.
That, for whatever reason, that like resonated with them. And so, yeah, so we would, you know, early on, we would have them pick their top rides that they wanted to ride that mm-hmm. we knew the lines were going to be long later. And we rode those until we were blue in the face. And then we would come August and July was purely water park.
Nice.
As we're going to the wave. They love Timbo Tides and Timbo Falls. The park has, nice. Like, it makes me emotional every year whenever we look at the height chart to see where mm-hmm. our kids have started, because they've truly grown up in the park. Like,
yeah.
even before mom worked at the park, you know, they each year we just hit new milestones.
Mm-hmm.
And, like, Madeline hit Raven this year. And it's just, you know, just all the fun pictures
yeah.
when I look back. And that very first one where we went when Madeline was about, I would say she was about 18 months old. It's just like little peach fuzz hair on top of her head. So I mean, I know I obviously love the park, but it's amazing how it's grown with us and our family over the years.
I love that.
Poof. I will not cry.
And that's why I wanted, like, other, you know, aside from us just sitting down and like shouting some or instead of us sitting down
yeah.
and shouting some perks at you, just wanted to share
yeah.
a personal story, your personal story
absolutely.
With the crowd. But yeah, so October 14th is the deadline for the best prices on season passes. Again, there's no gimmicks, there's mm-hmm. no changes. The best ones truly are right now.
Right.
And you know, I will call out a few perks of a few of these because I've got them sitting in front
right,
of me right
sure.
now. And Sabrina, I don't know if you want to call out kind of the things that drew you to upgrade over time.
Yeah. So I think for us, it was the food discounts. That's the thing that jumps the most.
Yep.
And I love, again, with the transparency, when you're making these decisions, you can decide what's important to you. So if, like, for us, like, you know, we were bringing a big group most of the time, and so we're like, oh, saving 20% on food, like, that automatically
yeah.
you know, you're saving so much per trip. That was huge for us.
And we've got plenty of families that do, you know, mom gets a platinum mm-hmm. pass because mom's always buying the meal,
right.
or, you know, whoever's always buying the meal, like,
yeah,
plenty of families do that. And, you know, until
yeah.
you realize how fun the platinum pass holder party is, that works.
Yeah, we did, for our family, we did, the oldest kid got the platinum pass. And then that way, if she was with grandma or
oh,
whoever,
smart.
Then
okay.
we could send the discounts that way.
Smart.
So we tried. And then, you know, like we have, like I said, my brother-in-law is active military. So you've got those bring a friend days.
Mm-hmm.
So for him, it didn't make sense to buy a pass because
yeah.
we knew a deployment was coming or he was going to be gone for training. Or even like my dad for a while, we didn't get him a pass. For the same reason.
Yeah.
He worked a lot of weekends when we were going. And so it made most sense to use those bring a friend days with them. Or, you know, and then we have those days like Father's Day and Mother's Day
mm-hmm.
occasionally will be,
yeah.
you know, bring a friend days
for
too.
25. Yep.
Mm-hmm.
It wasn't the $1 deals. I feel like those are a perk once you're there.
Oh, yeah. And then that's perfect for little ones. And then it's usually they're in good places to give mile markers and to entice good behavior.
Oh, nice.
I'm all about a good reward system. So,
yes.
You know, if it helps manage big emotions whenever you're in the park, you know, little
there
ones.
There are a lot of big emotions that come in a park like
they
that.
They do. You know? It's just so many stimulants and yep. a lot of, you know, they're feeding off all the excitement. So yep. It kind of helps us. It gives them something to look forward to during their trip.
Yeah. And then don't forget that also we have platinum pass holders. First of all, we have easy pay options available. Mm-hmm. Best discounts for those are available right now. But we also have, if you do decide to pay your platinum pass in full right now, you can visit for free on Sundays during Happy Halloween weekends.
Which is awesome.
Yes. And if you're an existing pass holder, I'm going to look at Josh and make sure that I say it correct. If you already have a, you know,
2021
pass and you have a 2022 platinum pass that you've paid in full as well, you get the second pass processed. Mm-hmm. And then you can bring a friend for free with that pass. That's the only time you will ever be allowed to use that pass for someone else. Mm-hmm. But you can bring a friend for free during Happy Halloween weekend Sundays. Did I check all the boxes, Josh?
Like Josh is like yeah. our brain on these things sometimes just because details are...
Well, and once you get talking, you can lose yes. track of your thoughts. So absolutely. I just want to make sure. Before we head out, I just want to call out a couple of holidays. Today is Canadian Thanksgiving, October 11th.
Hey.
So happy Thanksgiving to our Canadian friends. October 12th is Own Business Day, celebrating independent business owners, which,
hey-o. Hey. Fourth G.
FGO.
FGO-LK. Yeah.
Fourth generation owners here.
That's awesome.
Let's see. October 13th is Emergency Nurses Day.
Nice.
Yeah. Thank you, nurses. Mm-hmm. We have a nurse discount that's new this year. We know you guys have had a rough year, mm-hmm. so thank you. October 15th is World Students Day. October 16th is World Food Day. You know that's a good one.
We're interested. Tell me more.
And October 17th is Spreadsheet Day. So, you know, I can't let that one go without calling
Leah
it out.
Leah loves a strong spreadsheet.
I do. Well, congratulations. You've passed your way to the end of another episode. Please join us in 1 week during your next commute, cleaning session, etc. for our next episode, Season 3, Episode 20, the one with stamps? I'm always going to pronounce it that way. I could read all the rest of the stuff, but you already know it, and you'll hear it next week as well. That's so right. Please don't forget to share your feedback with us at podcast@holidayworld.com or reach out to us on social media, but especially Twitter, using the hashtag HOLOPO.
This has been Season 3 of the official Holiday World Podcast, a production of Holiday World and Splash and Safari in Santa Claus, Indiana. Listen to the latest episodes and subscribe at holidayworld.com/podcast. Thanks for being a part of our story as we celebrate 75 years of family fun.
For happy Halloween weekends, I'm going to be a soaring thunderbird.
I'll be a real bird, the raven, flying through the woods and over the water.
I'm feeling like a pilgrim on the voyage, going over one of the world's steepest drops.
Huh, guess I'm a mind reader. I already bought our Holiday World tickets.
Wow!
Yeah!
Woo! Be whatever you want at Holiday World each weekend through October. Do a corn maze, walk through the scare B&B, and go trick-or-treating. Get tickets at holidayworld.com.
Want to know a secret? The best time to buy season passes is always right now. It's that simple. We believe in transparent pricing, so there's no game to play and no complications. Prices increase throughout our off-season, so hurry and buy now. We have 3 different passes with different perks, so go to holidayworld.com/passes to pick the pass that fits your family best.